Hi guys, thanks for joining us in our first tutorial of our extended Snowflake series. I'm Tom Bruce, Delivery Lead at Snap Analytics, a UK-based analytics consultancy and Snowflake partner. And today I'll be showing you just how easy it is to scale up within Snowflake and get the instant benefits of scaling up. So what we'll be doing today is using the Snowflake demo dataset. So we have an external S3 storage location which has a series of CSV files representing different bike trips that have been taken within New York over the last 3 years. So I'll be creating this stage now, so we'll just create the link within Snowflake to that storage location. And if we list this stage, we should see all of those different files. So here we have each of the different CSV files. We can see we've got over 300 different CSV files representing different trips over that 3 year period. We'll create a trips table. So at the moment, we don't have any tables within our data warehouse. So we'll create a simple table to store each of these trips, just storing things like the trip duration, where did the trip start, where did the trip end, so we can start to do some geographical based analytics on that. And also some very basic customer information, things like the membership type, gender, so we can start to profile the customers of Citibike within New York. So I'll just create this table now. So we can see that's been successfully created, and if we refresh on the left-hand side, we should see that table has now been created. So we've created a table, just a blank table, so there's no rows yet loaded to it, and we'll then load that data in from the stage location. So that 300 CSV files that we saw earlier, we'll load that data using Snowflake's copy command. So I'll start loading that data in. Within Snowflake, you load using virtual warehouses. So you can see here we've got this load underscore WH, that's our virtual warehouse which we're using to load our data, and this is currently set to small, so that's just two servers. It's always best practice within Snowflake to have a warehouse set for loading and another warehouse to use for querying and for doing your analytics. That means that you don't get any resource contention, so we can have a bunch of users that are running reports at the same time as we're doing large data loads, and there will never be any resource contention at all. So that's again just another major benefit of using Snowflake. So if I open up the history, we can see that this load that we've done using our small virtual warehouse took 28.2 seconds, and we loaded 61.5 million records. So that performance is already really good. But there might be occasions where actually you need to change your warehouse size if you've got a data load which is needed to be completed quicker than usual, or if you have a particular complex transformation which takes longer to run, it might be that you need to scale up your servers to be able to load that quicker. So what I'll do is I'll just show you that we have loaded that in, so we've got 61.5 million records. I'll delete that data out of the table, so we'll truncate the table now. If I refresh, I should see that we've cleared the data out, so again we're back down to zero rows. And what I'll do is I'll scale up, so rather than using the small warehouse size that we had before, I'm going to change it to use a large warehouse, so using eight servers now. So just by clicking within the web UI, all that was just two clicks just to increase the warehouse size, and now we can rerun the exact same data load that we ran before. And the great thing about Snowflake is it's a zero management data warehouse, so I've been able to just increase the size without any kind of DevOps support needed. If you think back to your old kind of on-premise world, the amount of time that it would take to be able to scale up those servers, kind of you're looking at weeks rather than we've been able to just do this in two clicks and scale up within a matter of seconds. So now we can see that most recent load using our large virtual warehouse has been able to load 61.5 million records in just 11.1 seconds. So that kind of performance is really quite remarkable. I've obviously shown being able to scale up using the web UI. However, if you have a set of automated scripts, you can also do that via scripting. So within Snowflake, you can use the alter warehouse command. And obviously, we've already set this to be a large. So what I'll do is I'll set it back to a small virtual warehouse size. So if I just rerun this now, we can now see that this has changed it to be a small. And the power of doing this within your scripts themselves is that you can set these at the beginning of your scripts to run. So if you have automated transformations, if you have a particular complex transformation, it might be that you would alter the warehouse at the start of the script, set the size to be large to run one particular script, and then you could resize it back to being a small for all of the further processing, which might be less complex. So this gives you a lot more flexibility over your data loads, and gives you a lot of different ways to actually be able to control your data load schedule. I hope that this tutorial has been interesting and beneficial to you in terms of understanding just how easy it is to scale up within Snowflake. Stay tuned for our future videos within our extended Snowflake series. Thanks a lot. Bye-bye.